Mas, ah, pwede pala kumagay to
Ayun.
yun.
Okay.
Okay.
Go.
Good morning, fellow
Morning.
Toastmasters and guests. My name is Herman, and today I am the Sergeant at Arms for the club. I welcome you to the third meeting of the IMG Toastmasters Club. Moving forward, may I request each and everyone to please stand up and let us sing together our Philippine national anthem. Bayaw magiliw, ready sing.
Bayaw magiliw,
first ng sinilangan,
alam ng puso,
sa dilim ko'y buhay.
Lupa
kinihiran,
lumiyan ka ng pag-iting,
sa manlulubi,
di ka pasilisihin,
sa dalagan sa mundo,
sa simoy at sa langit mong magawa,
pinagtapat lahat ang mahal, ang kasamang watawat mo'y tatagpapay na nanginig,
ang bituin at
everyone to remain standing and follow after me for our club motto and mission, after which we will read together the Toastmaster promise. For better listening.
For better listening.
Better thinking.
For better speaking.
We learn by doing. We provide a supportive positive learning experience in which members are empowered to develop greater self-confidence, resulting in greater self-growth.
As a member of the Toastmasters International Club, I promise to attend club meetings regularly to prepare all of my projects based on my ability, basing them on the Toastmasters education program.
To provide fellow members with helpful structure evaluations, to help the club maintain the positive friendly environment necessary for all members to learn and grow, to serve my club as an officer when called upon to do so.
To treat my fellow club members and guests with respect and courtesy, to bring guests at the meeting so they can see the benefits of Toastmasters membership offers.
To adhere to the
guidelines,
and rules
for all those pastors,
educational and recognition programs.
To act within Toastmasters' core values of integrity,
respect, and excellence
during the conduct of all Toastmasters' activities.
Okay, thank you very much. You can take your seat now. In Toastmasters, there are three ground rules we need to follow. Number one, we are not allowed to discuss sex, politics, and religion. Number two, mute the microphone unless called upon to speak, and let your video on. Our theme for today, Ain't No Stopping Us Now. Yes, in IMG, Ain't No Stopping Us Now in achieving our goals. What we have first to start setting our goals. Because setting goals is the first step in turning the invisible into the visible. Without any further ado, I would like to introduce to you the person who will preside this meeting. He is an amazing and action taker entrepreneur, a likable speaker. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a round of applause to Toastmaster Virgilio Jack Cañete.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster Herman. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Morning. It's my honor to welcome you once again to our first meeting with the theme, Ain't Stopping Us Now. Congratulations to Toastmaster Herman for that equanimity's introduction of mine. And today, we will again learn and enjoy within our Toastmaster meeting. To start with, may I welcome our distinguished guest, first and foremost, our district director, Toastmaster, distinguished Toastmaster, Joy Villanueva. We also have our District Director Administrator, Toastmaster DTM Tess Villanueva. We also have guests for today. Wow, we have two guests. As I see in my screen, we have guest GR. Welcome, sir, to our meeting. And we also have guest Bradford. Welcome both of you, sir, to our meeting. This juncture, may I have our secretary to read to us our minutes of the meeting.
Good morning to everyone. Thank you.
Morning.
Our Toastmaster President, Sir Jack Cañete. At this moment, I will share to you our third minutes of meeting that we conducted last Friday, August 14, 12 o'clock noon, through online meeting. We had 21 present members, 3 absentees, and we don't have guests. Sergeant at Arms, Toastmaster Herman Romero started the meeting exactly at 12 o'clock noon with the singing of Philippine National Anthem, recited the club motto, mission and Toastmaster's promise, and called upon the President, Toastmaster Virgilio Cañete, to officially open the meeting. Club President, Toastmaster Virgilio Cañete, welcomed the guests. Reading of minutes of meeting was approved and dispensed. Our Toastmasters of that day, Toastmaster Rolando Arregla Jr., our General Evaluator, Distinguished Toastmaster Maria Teresa Villanueva, our Grammarian, Toastmaster Victoria Ginto, and our word of that day, Ebulent. Our counter, led by Toastmaster Gemark Labajo, our timer, Toastmaster Herman Romero, award master, yours truly, and our theme, Road to Success. Our first evaluator, Toastmaster Jasmine Consolacion, second evaluator, Toastmaster Benifer Consolacion. Our prepared speeches, speech number one, Toastmaster Virgilia Cañete, entitled Carriage. Toastmaster Jorbilia Hermosa, our second speaker, entitled The Pauper's Dream. Our table topics master, Toastmaster Cheryl D. Guzman. And our best of the best, prepared speech, Toastmaster Joy Villahermosa. Our speech evaluator goes to Toastmaster Benifer Consolacion. Table topics winner, Toastmaster Cara Ann Quinavista. And our general evaluator's report from distinguished Toastmaster Maria Teresa Villanueva congratulates all the role players for the job well done and recommended the following. First, encourage everyone to participate and take part as a role player in every Toastmaster meeting. Recommended to Sergeant at Arms to better lead in the singing of national anthem instead of using online videos for better synchronization. And we did that today. Good job. And we need to use Robert rule, use technical words. When adopt minutes of meeting, we better say, hearing none, the minutes of meeting is hereby approved and adopted. Or as corrected, the minutes of meeting has been approved and adopted. These two words, approved and adopted, should go hand in hand. Semi-formal attire was recommended, especially when you are a speaker. As a speaker, we need to be presentable in front of our audience, our listener. When you are called to speak, recommended to practice proper etiquette by giving recognition to the person who introduced or calling you to speak to formally transfer the authority for you to start your speech. Next, make sure to turn on your video if you are called to speak. In Toastmaster, it is not about how we speak, but how you use proper hand gesture, facial expression, and the manner of using of your totality as a speaker, especially when it's already a personal meeting. As table topic master, you are not allowed to give comments on how the speaker answered the questions. Rather, you can just reiterate a certain portion of what the speaker has said. As table topic speaker, to answer the questions that has given to you, it was suggested to use our listening skills. First, after you hear the question, listen and take a pause and build answer in your thought, then transform the question into an answer and make a conclusion at the end of your sentence. Next, recommended to the prepared speaker, to table topic speaker, and to our evaluator, that at least half of your body is visible during your speech. You are graded in totality as a speaker based on the manner of your hand gesture, inflection of your voice, and your facial expression. To become general evaluator, just remember the sandwich approach. First, you need to a commendation. Tell the strength of the speaker, followed by his or her improvement that need to be observed on his or her future speech. Second, recommendation. Give at least three suggestions about his or her speech in totality. Third, overall commendation. Give what you like about the speech and encourage speaker to participate again next time for her or him to build more confidence and maintain that strength to become a successful, or exceptionally good public speaker someday. As grammarian, we discourage the use of the phrase should be and must be. Use it will be better if instead. For our Toastmaster president, if possible, to reconsider the timing and the day of the IMGB on Toastmasters meeting, since not all of members are present during meetings due to their personal appointments or obligations. And the next meeting will be on Friday, that's today, August 21 at 12 o'clock noon, using the English language. Our meeting was adjourned at 2:59 p.m. That would be all. Back to you, Mr. President Virgilio Cagnetti. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Anna. Toastmaster Anna. Do we have any objection or any clarifications that you want to be included in our minutes? In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hearing none, I hereby approve and the minutes of meeting is hereby approved and adopted. Thank you very much, Toastmaster Anna. All right, so before we move forward, may I request our distinguished Toastmaster Joy Villanueva to give us any inspirational speech or opening speech or whatsoever, messages that you want us to hear from you before we move forward to our meeting.
Thank you very much, Mr. President, and to all the members and also the guests of IMGB1 Toastmasters Club. First, I say thank you and congratulations. Officially, the IMGB1 Toastmasters Club is officially chartered as one of the authorized and, of course, but if sinabing churches, then we are already recognized as official club in the Toastmasters International Saudi Arabia under District 104. And I am also very happy to tell you that our club is the first to be chartered in District 104 for this year. And hopefully, you're going to be the lucky club if we're going to have more clubs before we're going to end the year. In other words, we have not only conquered, but also overcome the challenge of establishing a club. Remember, to establish a club is not very easy. It is very difficult because you are going to put together people and minimum of that is 20. And where can you find an organization to find out people, with 20 people or more, that is focused on developing self and personal development? We wanted to be better version of ourselves, not only every week, but every day. And this is what we wanted. Why? Because we believe that if you consider yourself to be alive, you should be learning every day. You should be aspiring to know more. You should be aspiring to be a better you. And here in Toastmasters, that is the reality. For every time that we will have a meeting, we always study first, prepare for it, and deliver our best in every Toastmasters meeting. That's why in every meeting, it's like a laboratory in which we're going to put and test what we have in mind in order to check, is it acceptable? If the people understand it, if the message is delivered, all of this we are trying to put together and learn here in Toastmasters. So first, congratulations, officers. You are the chartered officers of this club. And for the members, especially the first one, those the first 20, you are also the chartered of this club. Remember when we chartered the Tanglao Toastmasters Club 25 years ago? We are like putting one seed. But the seeds, or the seed grown and has produced not only 2, 3, 4, we have produced hundreds of clubs. And imagine hundreds of clubs at 20. It means that we have at least tried our best to add to the value of one individual that we put and help share and mold in Toastmasters. So congratulations to our sponsor, our chairman of creating clubs in District 104, Chairman Ben Consolacion, which is also the president of the only Filipino speaking language in the whole world, that is the Comfy Toastmasters Club, and of course to our admin manager, the Singis Toastmaster, Tess Villanueva. And to all of you, I say thank you. I hope that your membership in Toastmasters was the beginning of dreaming to have more learning, because we can only share what we have. We learn more in order to share to others. Welcome to officially welcome to Toastmasters International, and of course, our club. Welcome to Toastmasters International District 104. Good morning.
Very good morning and congratulations to all members and officers of IMGB1 Toastmasters Club family. Okay, so again, may I welcome, we have new in our web, in our meeting, a guest, I believe, number one, E.K. 60, may I request this person to, may I request this guest to rename, if he can or she can rename, please. Also, I would like to acknowledge, he left the group. So, another guest, Ma'am Annalyn from Philippines, as mentioned. Also, I forgot to acknowledge one of our sponsor of this club and the Comfy President, Toastmaster Ben. Thank you very much. All right, so moving forward, may I introduce to you now our Toastmaster of the day. And I hope that you are so excited, especially all the speakers. Are you then all excited for this meeting? Wow, I see all the enthusiastic face of our speakers. All right, so our Toastmaster of the day is a teacher by profession. He is a graduate of political science and secondary education, major in history. He holds master's and doctorate degree in public administration, a graduate and undergraduate school professor, and presently working at Prince Sultan University, an enthusiastic leader, a good motivator. Please help me welcome our Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Joy Villahermosa. Can you please give him a round of applause?
Good morning, everyone. I can see the beautiful smiles to all our participants today. Thank you so much, Toastmasters President Jack Cañete, for that introduction. Our Sergeant at Arms Herman Romero, and of course, to my fellow Toastmasters, good afternoon, and most especially to our distinguished Toastmasters, Joey Villanueva and Tess Villanueva. Thank you so much for bearing with us, for supporting with the mission of Toastmasters B1 in Saudi Arabia. And thank you so much that we will be able to surely fulfill what we wanted to achieve in this endeavor with all your support. Now, in this afternoon, I believe that the equanimity of today's weather brings joy and happiness, as well as the sweetest smiles to everyone, makes this event a successful endeavor. I believe that we have assigned a joke master for today. If there is none, do we have a joke master, Vice President for Education? Okay, so if there is none, so I believe that it is time to proceed and witness for this afternoon the showcasing of the amazing talents in communication and presentation skills by our presenters for this afternoon of their icebreaker speech and the project, the first project speech. Now, to call on the first speaker, he is a native of Baguio, and he defines success as overcoming failure. And he further said that if he has to fail, he has to fail forward. He is, you know, he is known to be a shy guy. So that's why this afternoon he will be telling us his journey, how this shy guy propelled
the role players.
Yes.
The role players.
So, Marlon Bautista.
Doc, your point of order.
Yes, sir.
I think we still need to call the role players for today before proceeding to the speakers.
Okay. So just the name first. It's a good practice in a way. Okay, so our first speaker is Marlon Bautista. Is he around?
Sir, I think we will first call on the role, the role players.
Role players.
The accountant, grammarian, etc.
Okay, so just a rewind. So may I call in now our respective role players for today. So may we start from the accountant. Please tell us about your role. Toastmaster Anna Rose Rama.
As an accounter, by the way, thank you, PM Joy Villahermosa. Good morning. As an accounter, the purpose of the accounter is to note any overused words or filler sounds used as a crutch by anyone who speaks during the meeting. Words may be inappropriate interjections, such as and, well, but, so, and you know. Sounds may be or er. And as a counter, at the end of the meeting, I will declare the Tarzan of the evening who have used the most filler words. Back to you, TM Joy Villahermosa.
Okay, thank you so much, TM Ann. Now, salute to our grammarian of the day, Toastmasters Ray Kinivista. Toastmasters Ray.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the Day, Sir Joy. For grammarian, while the timer polices time during a meeting, the grammarian polices language. A big challenge in public speaking is to avoid crutch words whenever possible. Like, these are some of the most common space fillers used in speech, and the grammarian tracks occurrences of each word, providing an overall tally at the end of each meeting. The grammarian also notes any bad grammar and incorrect word usage that might occur. But it is not all doom and gloom in this role. The grammarian also tracks their end reports on good language, interesting phrases, inventive word choice, and speech creativity in general. Additionally, the grammarian provides the word of the week for each meeting. You are all encouraged to use the word throughout the meeting. At the end of the meeting, I will provide a report tallying crutch words, word of week usage, and any creative language or word use that has occurred. And for our word of the day, which is equanimity. Equanimity is a noun, which means calmness and composure, especially in a difficult situation. For example, as Toastmasters, we need to accept both the good and the bad with equanimity. That's all. Thank you, Toastmaster of the Day, Sir Choi.
Okay, thank you so much, Toastmasters Ray. Now, can we hear our timer of the day, Toastmasters Herman Romero?
Thank you very much, Doc Joy. Today, it takes a lot or a ton of equanimity as a timer to be a truly effective speaker. A person should be comfortable speaking at varying lengths. Sometimes a long speech is required. Other times a brief toss is more appropriate. It is also important to be respectful of the amount of time you have been given to speak. As a timer, it is my responsibility to let all speakers and participants know if they are still within their allotted time. Formal speeches could range anywhere from 5 to 10 minutes. At 5 minutes, the green lights will be on. At 6 minutes, the yellow lights will be on. At 7 minutes, the red light will be on and will remain until the speaker finishes his or her speech. The speaker is given 30 seconds to wrap up his or her speech. For table topic speakers, they are given 2 minutes to deliver their speeches. At 1 minute, the green light will be on. At 1 minute and 30 seconds, the yellow light will be on. At 2 minutes, the red light will be on and will remain on until the speaker finishes his or her speech. The speaker is given 30 seconds to wrap up his or her speech. For a speech evaluator, they are given 2 to 3 minutes to finish their evaluations. At 2 minutes, the green light will be on. At 2 minutes and 30 seconds, the yellow light will be on. At 3 minutes, the red light will be on and will remain until he or she finishes his evaluations. Once called upon by the Toastmasters of the day, I will report the time used by each speaker in every segment of the meeting. Back to you, Toastmaster Joy.
Thank you so much, Toastmasters Herman. Now, may I call in our award master, Toastmasters Cara Pinivista.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster of the Day. And good day to all of you, to our distinguished Toastmaster, fellow Toastmaster and guests. So as an award master, I will be awarding today 3 categories, which is Best Table Topic Speaker, Best Evaluator, and Best Speaker. Please vote for each category. So I think we're going to vote using the poll. And votes will be collected and I will be reporting, I will report the winners and award them at the end of the meeting. And back to you, Toastmaster of the Day, Doc Joy.
Okay, thank you so much, Toastmaster Scara. Now, our evaluator, Toastmasters Gina Hill. So you can have the floor. Toastmasters Gina, this is around.
Thank you very much, our Toastmaster of the Day, Toastmaster Joy. The general evaluator's role is to give an overall assessment of how the meeting has run at the end of the meeting. The objective is to provide feedback to as many members as possible, but especially the evaluators on what they have done well and to offer some suggestions for improvement. I will also be commenting on the overall planning, preparation, atmosphere, dynamics of the meeting. We will be having, for the benefits of the guests, we will be having three parts on the evaluation. First is to introduce the tag team, which is the timer, the grammarian, and the accounter. And the second segment will be the evaluators who will be evaluating our prepared speakers. And the third segment will be reporting my overall observation of the proceeding of the meeting. Back to you, Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Joy.
Thank you so much, our general evaluator, Gina Hill. Now, to give some opening remarks for the specific speakers of the day, so may I call in the evaluator for the first speaker, Toastmasters Rolando John Ariglo.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Joy Villahermosa. Distinguished Toastmasters, fellow Toastmasters, and guests, ain't no stopping us now. Just like our first speaker of the day, Toastmaster Marlon Bautista. There's no stopping him in introducing himself to the club today, fellow Toastmasters. He will be delivering his icebreaker speech entitled Shy Guy. I can sense equanimity in him right now. I will be evaluating him in all aspects of his speech. The manner that he delivers his speech, his mannerisms, gestures, and the totality of his speech. I will be evaluating his strengths and make suggestions and recommendations. Back to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you so much, Toastmasters John Ariglo. Now for our second speaker of the day, may I call on Toastmasters Pearly Milad to give her opening talk about the speaker.
On behalf of Toastmaster Pearly, I will be the second evaluator for our second speaker for her icebreaker speech titled Victorious Victoria. Toastmaster Victoria, you have the following objective in this speech. First is you need to introduce yourself. And the second objective is begin to conquer the fear of speaking in front of us. And the third one is to provide a baseline on your current strength and weakness. Like a goal, I cannot wait anymore. Your time to speech, time to shine here in Toastmasters. Back to you, Toastmaster Joy.
Okay, thank you so much, Toastmasters Ben, for that introduction. Now, we will again hear from Toastmasters Johanna de la Peña to give her opening remarks for our third speaker, which is actually different. No, she will be delivering a speech different from the first two speakers. It is all about the speech project one, because if we remember that she already delivered about 2 weeks ago her icebreaker speech. Now, may I call in Toastmasters Johanna de la Peña.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day, fellow Toastmaster, and my dear guests. Good afternoon, everyone. I am evaluator of our third speaker today to deliver her first project. The title, Expectation versus Reality. And the purpose of this project is for the members to present a speech on any topic, receive feedback and apply, and the feedback to a second speech. And the purpose of this speech is to member to present a speech and receive feedback from the evaluator. You have 5 to 7 minutes to deliver your speech. Good luck to your first project, Toastmaster Shearer. Back to you, Toastmaster of the Day.
Okay, so thank you so much, Toastmasters Johanna de la Peña. Now, are you ready? I know that everyone is excited with the prepared speeches of our speakers for today, because I know that all of them are ready to deliver the life story of their journeys in life towards success. Now, first is that we'll be hearing a native from Baguio. He called himself as a shy guy. Now, ladies and gentlemen, to probe us how his being shy led him into achieving success in life. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Toastmasters Marlon Bautista.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the Day, Dr. Joy. Kindly, please confirm if you hear me clearly.
Yes, yes.
Yes, I guess.
Okay, thank you. I have always been shy and anxious. I am so nervous to speak in public. My knees are shaking. My heart is pumping. And I can't even remember what I have to say. Even right now, I am so nervous, and it is my first time to talk in front of the people. Well, virtually, but can you imagine? If this is an actual meeting, I could have been melted in fear. Distinguished Toastmasters and lovely guests, good afternoon. Since I was a kid in grade school, I've been scared in talking to new faces. New faces scare me. I rather sit at the back and talk to no one. I am nervous in recitations and in talking in front of the class. In my high school years, the same character I have. I am so shy that I could not even say hi or good morning to my crush at that time. During my college years, the same nervousness, fear, and lack of confidence I observed with my personality. We had a subject before, which is public speaking. If I remember correctly, that was our English 4 subject. I hardly passed this subject because of my low self-esteem. Did you know that even courting my wife, I am so shy. I have no guts to ask her out for dinner or for lunch. Luckily, I am a millennial. I have access to internet and social media, the Facebook. Can you imagine? I courted her in a modern way. We exchange chat messages, play online games, just to have interaction. Virtually, I use these platforms to my advantage. But the day when we first met came and went out on a date, I am so nervous that my words are mumbling and I could not fully express what I wanted to say. Fast forward, now that I am an adult, I thought I can get away with this weakness that I have. I try to analyze and find what is the real cause of this nervousness. I used root cause analysis. This is a technique that we use in plant operation to identify the reason of process malfunction and failures. Being a technical person, a chemical engineer, I try to incorporate technical ways on how to further improve my personality. Soon enough, I found the main cause. It is a major problem that needs to be corrected or troubleshoot in order for me or the whole plant operation to function effectively and achieve the desired results. The main reason of my extreme nervousness when talking to people, especially in public, is obviously lack of self-confidence. But why I lack self-confidence? What must be the reason? I further investigated a more distinct causes of this weakness. I found two reasons. The first one is that I lack substantial knowledge and information in a particular subject. When you have a little or limited knowledge of something, you begin to limit yourself. You begin to limit your confidence to interact with people discussing that particular topic. Most especially if those people are not your friends. The second reason why I lack confidence is that I am more concerned of what other people think about me when I express my insights and thoughts rather than being true to myself. This is deep. And I think most people are like this. They are limited and don't believe in themselves. They rather please the people that they don't care about rather than pleasing, elevating, and believing in themselves. Intelligence is the ability to make finer distinctions. If you cannot identify a problem, you can never solve the problem. The lessons that I gained from this analysis is number one, be adequate in knowledge and information. Read. Research. Do your due diligence. Do your homework so that in time of interactions, you have something to share. It will somehow increase or boost your confidence and have the self-esteem that is needed in that particular moment. Number two, what other people think about you is none of your business. You cannot control what other people think. They will judge you, but do not concern yourself with this. Mind your own business. Just be sure that what you are doing is the right thing to do. To sum it up, we can always turn our weakness into a strength. This will be beneficial throughout our lifetime. But in doing so, it requires a tremendous willpower and strict self-discipline. It will take a lot of courage to change a trait or weakness that is hardened in our personality. But I'm taking the first step. That's why I'm here. This will be the beginning of my journey to become an effective public speaker. Sooner or later, it will be just in the memory that I was once a shy guy. Good afternoon. Back to you, Toastmaster of the Day.
Okay, so thank you so much, Toastmasters Marlon. Now, indeed, that as you delivered your speech, we can truly feel and see your equanimity, yet full of confidence in delivering your speech. So keep it up, and we look forward for more speeches from you, Toastmasters Marlon.
Thank you.
Now, our second speaker for today wants to be called Victoria. And her speech is named before her name. And now we will find out and witness how victorious she is in her way and conquered life's challenges. She is a native from Mindoro, and she defines success as something you have achieved and accomplished. Ladies and gentlemen, the victorious Victoria.
Victoria! Victoria! One more seat, and this jeepney will soon leave. Hey, last one passenger! Victoria! Victoria! Distinguished Toastmasters and guests, good afternoon. When I was young, I didn't like my name, Victoria. Yes, because every time I hear a caller from a jeepney terminal shout my name, Victoria, a town in Mindoro, I get annoyed and feel that it was the worst name ever. When I entered high school, one teacher asked me to introduce myself, explaining the meaning of my name. I never had any idea what it was. According to my parents, they got it from a calendar hanging on a wall. So I went to the school's library and looked for the meaning of my name. I was really surprised upon knowing that my name has a powerful meaning. It means strong and victorious. But as I grew up, that definition became so vague, senseless, and forgotten. I was raised in a family with lots of sad memories. My father, stowed away from Negros Occidental, decided to go to Manila to look for his aunt who helped him survive in his life. My mother, who never finished elementary, left summer when she was young. Both of them worked and survived on their own. They met in Laguna, got married there, and then on September 9, 1971, I was born. After a year, we moved to Mindoro and started our life there. Because my father is 20 years older than my mother, almost every day we would wake up hearing them shouting and yelling at each other. Almost every day we hear them fight, arguing about money, about jobs, about my father's vices like cockfighting, drinking, and smoking habits. It broke my heart. And I was devastated. Despite all this, they were good providers. They see to it that we have food on our table to eat. Until one day my father told me one semester in college, we can no longer provide your schooling, Victoria. You must stop. You are not the only one who is studying here. There are 5 other boys after you, so you better stop this coming semester. We cannot afford any more. My father admitted. It was the most painful words I heard from my father. I was devastated, but I never lost hope. I stopped for one semester, and when with my equanimity, applied for a job in a small carinteria near our house. I told the owner that I was willing to work without any salary, but that they must pay my tuition in college. I never thought whether my compensation was enough or not for the work I did. There, I worked as early as 5 in the morning, went to school at 3 p.m., go back to work again at 7:30, and went home to sleep at 11 p.m. Working in a restaurant is a tough job. I wash dishes and pots. I carried bottles of soft drinks. I served food, made ice bags, everything. I even remember hiding my hands with my classmates because it was soaked with soap and water for many hours of dish washing. Good. I was young then. I have lots of energy and equanimity. That cycle continued for 4 years until I finished my bachelor degree. After graduation, I immediately took the licensure examination, but unfortunately, I became devastated again for not passing it the first time. The next year after, I took it again and passed it. I started my job as a high school teacher in one of the public schools in Mindoro, and from then on, I was able to help my parents for the family's expenses, which made my father and my mother very happy and proud. I worked so hard until one day, my father got sick due to heart problem and died after a few days in the hospital. I became devastated again because I was so close to him and I am the apple of his eyes. I even look like him. After a year, I got married, which made my mother furious because she never liked and accepted my husband. She went to the mayor and warned him not to allow us to get married. Because I was already 30 then, the mayor advised my mother to accept us, but she never did. And that made me devastated again. Despite that, we created good memories as a couple. We are happy even if the world is against us. With equanimity in our minds and hearts, we raised three beautiful and adorable girls and made them happy children. But life is not always a bed of roses. Few years later, my mother was hospitalized due to back pain, which made her unable to walk. Her feet and limbs started to deteriorate. She became irritable, thin, and bedridden. I took care of him and brought her to orthopedic hospital. My pockets were empty. I had loans here and there. For us to survive in Manila together with my brother, I asked help from different government agencies to support the medical expenses of my mother. But a year after, she died and made me devastated again. This time, I was already sinking in debt. I do not know what to do with my life. What I only have is my husband, my children, my job, and my faith that everything will be all right. I even remember crying and kneeling in adoration chapel begging for help. We continued to be strong despite these devastating events in my life. We look for ways to survive. Because of my husband's full support, we engaged into different businesses like delivering buko juice in a school canteen, photocopying business, selling homemade fishballs and kekyam for students like during recess. With these hardships, opportunity came coming to Saudi Arabia for another life story. I brought my husband and eventually my kids, and now happily staying here for almost 13 years. I was devastated and never lose hope. I fell many times and stood up again. I was weak, but I learned to be strong and victorious because of my name, Victoria. Back to you, Toastmaster of the Day.
Okay, thank you so much, Toastmasters Victoria Ginto. Now, I can see the brevity in your eyes, yet empowered with equanimity, that your speech is tantamount to emotion seconded of your being an eloquent speaker of the second language as a language teacher. You are capacity. That's Victoria Ginto.
Thank you.
Now to proceed with our lone speaker for her second speech project. She is a native of Cebu or from Cebu. She defines success as an accomplished purpose. She will be with us to present her speech entitled Expectations versus Reality. The Marvelous Woman from Cebu. Cheryl, Toastmasters, Cheryl Mortilla.
Between our expectations in life and the reality, there is a clear-cut difference. Expectations are those that we consider as possible and likely to occur. What's reality, on the other hand, is the state of things as they are. Fellow Toastmasters, distinguished guests, do you set some expectations, yet it came in a totally different package? Is tall, dark, and handsome familiar to our ladies here? Is that what you also set as your ideal man? Now, growing up, I was so focused on my studies and building up a career at my young age that I only experienced being into a relationship when I was 27 years old. Yes, you heard it right. First boyfriend at 27. So no boyfriend since birth, within 27 years. And being a late bloomer, I told myself, I should consider not to settle for less before entering into a relationship. I wanted to be with someone who is smart, so to enjoy a conversation with him of any topic under the sun. I wanted someone who is as good looking as Pierce Brosnan and have my own 007. Being an area supervisor already at that stage, I again told myself, I should not get someone, but as somebody who is the best boyfriend material. Not realizing that I set an ideal man that can only be found in pocketbooks. First, with this desire to have an ideal man, I went through some failed relationships, not just once, but twice. First, with a basketball player and at the same time a T-shirt brand model in Cebu, whom I thought is a perfect guy, close enough to my set criteria of an ideal man. Sad truth is,
we lost
Toastmasters Cheryl. We can't hear you.
Hello?
Yes, we can hear you now.
Okay,
it's choppy again. Any action from our Toastmasters President, Jack Cañete, regarding this issue?
I think we need to wait.
Or maybe to our timer, we still have time.
Speaker number 3, Cheryl, network bandwidth is low. I think the internet signal.
Mr. President, if it will not be possible, then probably we can again ask our Toastmaster Cheryl to deliver her speech next meeting.
Okay, so since that there is an existing internet issue from Toastmaster Cheryl, so I think we can proceed. Now, based on the speeches delivered by our two speakers, as manifested on their delivered speeches, so truly there was an equanimity in their emotions in expressing real feelings that eventually catches the audience through the equanimity of their blind eyes blinks. Now, to proceed with, may I call in our timekeeper to give us the time where the speeches has been delivered. Toastmasters Herman Romero. Toastmasters Herman.
You need to unmute, please.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster of the Day, Doc Joy, for the time incurred for the formal speeches. For the shy guy, Toastmaster Marlon Bautista, he finished his speech at 7 minutes and 59.23 seconds. And the victorious Victoria, Toastmaster Victoria Gold, she finished her speech at 7 minutes and 29.15 seconds. Back to you, Toastmaster of the Day, Doc Joy.
Okay, so thank you so much, Toastmasters Herman. Now, after those prepared speeches, let's move forward, no? And ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce to you our table topic master, Virgilio Jack Cañete.
Ako na naman daw yung GE, may emergency si Jim na. Ano ba yan? Lagi na lang ganun?
Good morning, Pillow Toastmasters!
Good morning!
Alright, so welcome now to our next segment of our program, which is the table topic session, and for sure, the most exciting one. Why? Because we need to speak and prepared. And today, we will be having 7 questions that will be distributed all throughout the members. And with your lucky day, you will be called upon by me to illustrate and demonstrate further about our meeting for today or about our meeting agenda. But may I request first and foremost the DTM test to please allow me to share my screen in order for me to share the prepared questions that I prepared with.
Right,
there you go.
Ah. By the way, Mr. Table Topics Master, before you proceed, we just would like to announce that there will be no votation for the prepared speaker, considering that the second speaker is overtime.
Yes, I agree. I think all the speakers are overtime. All right. Table topic session, and no stopping us now. It's a classic song, 1979 song by Mac Fadden and Whitehead. I don't know if you hear this song before. This is where I talk with the happy. What that? Yes, ladies and gentlemen, ain't no stopping us now in achieving our communication and leadership skills here in Toastmasters. And I will be calling, based on this presentation, the names who will answer questions about and in relation to our topic for today. Ain't no stopping us now. For the guest that will be called, you can present or state your name and your location, and if you can tell something about yourself thereafter. Are you excited? Okay, so to answer our first question, let me call on. Yes, first speaker for our table topic session, Distinguished Toastmaster Maria Teresa Villanueva.
Go ahead,
Mr. Toastmaster.
Master, and your question is, and no stopping us now. I made it from my bed to the coffee maker. There's no stopping me now. Please elaborate further, and you can relate your question to your personal experience.
Mr. Table Topics Master, to our fellow Toastmasters and our distinguished guests, good afternoon. Do you believe that in every individual, there's no such thing as stopping you right now? If you are going to ask me, if you are going to ask with every experience, with every details of our lives, it will only define on how you define yourself. Is there no stopping you right now? For me, there is no stopping me right now. I have made it from my bed to the coffee maker, from coffee maker to my bed. This is how I define my life cycle every day. When you try to finish everything in a 24 hour and you feel that 24 hour is not enough for you to fulfill your dreams, to fulfill the challenges and the opportunities that you have on hand, then there is no stopping me right now. When you are given responsibilities, there is no ifs, there is no buts. There is no why. There is no how. It is all about on how you were able to schedule yourself. When we try to combine the Toastmasters and IMG in our day-to-day life, then you could imagine the gargantuan task that you have to encounter. You could imagine on how you could be able to support and guide of all those people that are within your family. Aside from that, as a wife, as a career woman, as a mother of four, as the breadwinner of our extended family, all of this, you have to put it in one box for you to be able to fulfill all of them. I still imagine that we are given 24 hours, right? But why is it that for some people who doesn't dream big, they will always have to say, I am busy? Probably, Tita Tess, yes, but. Yes, I can do it, Tita Tess, but why? Yes, Tita Tess, we can do it, but probably not now. It's not yet the right time. Then what my question is, when is the right time for you? When is the right time for me? When we already reach the end of the tunnel? When we are already pushed to the wall to do something? I can say that, yes, life is not an easy task. Life is not a bed full of roses. All we have to do is we have to be calm. We have to focus. We have to dream big. Because in dreaming big, then for me, there is no stopping me right now to fulfill that dreams. Mr. Table Topics Master.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster Tess, for end stopping you now in dreaming. All right, moving forward. Let me reiterate, if I forget it, to mention that our table topics will be 2 to 3 minutes. When you will see the green light from our Sergeant at Arms, it means that you have reached the minimum time required to speak. When you will see the yellow light, means that you are halfway between the minimum and the maximum time required. And if you will see the red light, means that you reach the maximum time required and you only have given 30 seconds to wrap up your speech. And to proceed further to our next speaker, the lucky one who will give us further explanation about and no stopping him now. Let me call on Ma'am Lilibeth. Is Ma'am Lilibeth around? I saw her this morning. Ma'am Lilibeth, kindly acknowledge.
Afternoon, Toastmaster.
John. Yes, Ma'am Lilibeth, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
And here is your question. And no stopping us now. With the right tools, you will be unstoppable. With the right tools, you will be unstoppable. Fellow Toastmasters, Toastmaster Lilibeth Zagul.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster, Table Topic Toastmaster Jack Kanyete. With the right tools, I will be unstoppable. For example, like the one we have now in IMG. Now we are in the system and everything. We just follow the system and then we can get our own what we want to do, what we want to get our position in the company. Like for us now I reach my as SMD. No one can stop us for me now. And then I want to do more, to get more my what I want to be later on. That's why I will do my best right now, together with my team. And I will help them also to reach their own position, what they will do. Not only just SMD, can be more than that. That is like your mindset to reach this goal, to reach the point until you will be feeling happiness, satisfaction, and thanks God that you reach, that you can get this one. That is through your eagerness to get what you want to do. That is all, Table Topic Master. Thank you so much.
Yes, Ma'am Lilibeth, you are right. With the right tools, you are unstoppable. And congratulations. All right. Are you enjoying? Or are you excited?
Yes.
Yes.
Our next speaker to answer question number 3. Toastmaster Amor. Is Toastmaster Amor around?
Yes, good afternoon, Toastmaster Jack.
Yes, Toastmaster Amor, good afternoon. Your question number three, and no stopping us now. So you can, you take a chance and don't ever look back. So take a chance and don't ever look back. Ladies and gentlemen, Toastmaster Amor Cabalar.
Yes, good afternoon to my fellow Toastmasters. I just remember the moment when our CEO invited me or offered me to give orientation for our ongoing IMG seminars, webinar. So I did accept the challenge. So I asked God for the spirit of equanimity. If there's a chance now, I have to grab the moment because I know chance only pass once. So really I choose to have the challenge. I prepared almost 1 week, but only finalized on the remaining 2 nights. And our CEO knows this. I have to confess really, because I gained the spirit of equanimity. When I told her at the last moment, I said, CEO, I think I cannot deliver today. And the remaining is only 2 hours. And she encouraged me, no, you can do it. You can do it. I know you can do it. So at 30 minutes, I decided to go on. So I thank everybody. I thank God for that spirit of equanimity. So during the delivery, I have the calmness, and I think everybody who listened to me, they at least gained something, a lesson, to go at least. So that's all. Thank you very much, Toastmaster Jack Kanyete.
Thank you, Toastmaster Amor. So indeed, you take a chance, and you are in the right path for sure. Thank you very much, Toastmaster Amor, and we'll proceed to our next Stable Topics speaker. Our fourth Stable Topics speaker, let me call on our guest, lucky guest for today, guest JR. Guest JR, are you around? Guest JR? Can you please unmute yourself? If you can introduce yourself to us or you want to answer a question. Guest JR? Okay, I think the guest GR is not shy to answer maybe as he did not unmute himself as of this moment. So we will leave for a while and we will call him after at the end of the meeting to share us his experience with us. All right, to proceed to our next speaker, may I call on? Ma'am Grace. Ma'am Grace? Is Ma'am Grace around? Okay, so we'll proceed. Ma'am Cara. Ma'am Cara, good afternoon. Are you around? I saw her.
Yes, po. Table topic master.
Yes, Ma'am Cara. You are lucky to get our fourth question. And your question is, and no stopping us now. Stop being afraid of what you can go wrong and start being positive about what can go right. Toastmaster Cara, stop being afraid of what can go wrong and start being positive about what can go right. Toastmaster Cara, the floor is yours.
Thank you so much, Table Topic Master Jack Cañete, and to our distinguished Toastmaster, fellow Toastmaster, and beloved guest, good day to all of you. So for me, what I can relate to this phrases or sayings is that whatever thing that I'm doing is that I've been always positive, and I always take the chance that the things that I'm going to do is to be positive and stop being afraid of what is wrong, what are the things that it's going to do, but just stay positive on whatever things that you're going to do. Because if you stay positive on the doings or things that is on you, is you will reach your goal, you will reach your destination. So be positive, and I think that if I continue to be positive in every way, nothing can stop me, because that's my goal, that's my success in life. I think that's all, Table Topic Master. Back to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Cara. I sense the positivity in you. Congratulations. All right, moving forward, may I call on our next Table Topic speaker? Toastmaster Annie Rose. Toastmaster Annie Rose.
Yes, I'm here.
Here is your question. And no stopping us now. I hated every minute of training, but I said, don't quit. Suffer now, live the rest of your life as a champion. From Muhammad Ali. Toastmaster Anna Rose, the floor is yours.
To my distinguished Toastmasters, fellow Toastmaster, respective guests, and Toastmaster of the day, good afternoon. Ain't no stopping me right now. Even though sometimes, yes, I admit that in every minute of training, sometimes you're lazy to attend whenever you're tired from your duty, from your work. However, I just want to rest, but no quitting on it. Because I believe suffering now, make an effort now, even though you're tired, even though you're not in a good state of mind, just attend training. There's no bad thing about it. Because for sure, in the future, you will thank yourself for it. And no one will gonna stop you. Even though speaking in front of other people give me butterfly in my stomach, sweaty palm, cannot even utter any words because of nervousness. But still, I am here attending trainings, attending Toastmasters, because I know for sure in the future, it will make me as a champion and as an effective public speaker. That would be all. Back to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster Anne. Indeed, continue, and for sure, you will be a champion. Moving forward, let me hear our next speaker. Toastmaster Herman, I know that you are the timer, but can we wave? Okay, we will proceed to the next one. As you are the timer, Toastmaster Rodolfo. Toastmaster Rodolfo, yeah. Are you around?
Yeah, I'm feeling good, but anyway, I still respond to this patient.
Wow. Thank you very much for taking the challenge.
Yeah, Toastmaster and everybody, Major Toastmaster and distinguished Toastmaster.
Yeah. It will soon, but for sure it will help you answer this next question. Yeah. And no stopping us now. During your life, never stop dreaming. No one can take away your dreams. Ladies and gentlemen, Toastmaster Rodolfo Redal.
Paul, good afternoon to all of you, my fellow Toastmaster and distinguished Toastmaster. In the call of equanimity, I will respond to the situation today, so no one is stopping me. During your life, never stop dreaming. No one can take away your dreams. These words put me in fueling myself when I was young. I saw this in my spiritual books, Happy the young man who have a dream. I thought dream is only for sleeping. But anyway, dreaming is a force to ourselves. It's a life force to make us more interesting, enthusiastic, with the equanimity power in ourselves. There is our relatives, father, mother, or other friends, but in yourself, you are the one who make your dreams, like Joseph, of the son of Jacob. He's a dreamer, you know. People are his brother called him a dreamer, but at the end of his life, he was second in command in Pharaoh, and the success with him. And all the people on the tribe of the Israel was with him because of his dream. So dreaming is not part only by sleeping. Dreaming is a reality of life. We are living in the reality of life in this world. Therefore, dreaming is not a dream. It's a true possessions of our life. If we face it, equanimity in our life. Back to you, Toastmaster, and thank you. Bye-bye.
Yes, thank you very much, Toastmaster. What happened? Wait. Yes, thank you very much, Toastmaster Rodolfo. Indeed, no one can take away your dreams. All right, moving forward, let me call on our last speaker to answer us this table topics question. Dr. Joy is our... Is Toastmaster Mark around? Mark Douglas?
I think he is not around, Sir President.
All right, we'll change for the last speaker. Mom Shinley is around. Is Mom Shinley around? I saw her a while ago. Again, she's not around. Let us proceed to the next last one. Toastmaster J. Mark. Toastmaster J. Mark. Is Toastmaster J. Mark around? I think none.
I think he's not here also.
Now let me call on Toastmaster June Rolando to answer this last question for our table topics question. Master June.
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much. I know that you are the evaluator, but since the lucky picker picks you, then it's your day. And no stopping us now. And your question is, you don't need to see the whole staircase. Just take the first step. You don't need to see the whole staircase. Just take the first step. Toastmaster June Areglo Jr. The floor is yours, sir.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster of the Day, Toastmaster Jack Anyete. Distinguished Toastmasters, fellow Toastmasters, and our beloved guests, good afternoon. We don't need to see the whole staircase just to take the first step. They say, for us to be able to succeed in life, we just need that first step in life. Yes, that first step in life is the most difficult thing of all to do. But ain't no stopping me to do that. Nobody, nothing can stop me in stepping that first ladder to success. And if I will be able to do that, I will be clearly in the horizon and I will see the rest of the steps along the path to success. Yes, I believe that in this life, there are always tribulations. There are always hardships, ladies and gentlemen. But with the help of our Almighty, with the help of our Lord, then for me to be able to achieve that first ladder of success, then I must believe in myself. I just have faith in myself. And once I am there on the first level of my step, clearly the pathway to success is for me to achieve. Ladies and gentlemen, back to you, Toastmaster of the Day.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster June. Indeed, you show us the way in answering that question. Thank you very much. And may I now request our timer, if all our speakers are qualified for voting. Toastmaster Herman, please unmute yourself.
Thank you so much, Table Topic Master Jack Anyete. For the Table Topic speakers, out of the seven, there were two who were exceeded the time, and these were Maria Teresa Villanueva and Toastmaster Amor. The five Table Topic speakers within the 2 minute period. Back to you, Toastmaster Jack Anyete.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, you can now start voting to our Table Topics speaker amongst Toastmaster Lilibeth, Toastmaster Amor, Toastmaster Cara, Toastmaster Aniros, Toastmaster Rodolfo, and Toastmaster June Areglo. And I believe our pool already there, you can choose amongst those speakers. So thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for participating to our Table Topics question and Table Topics segment. I hope that you've learned and conquered the first step in answering Table Topics or unprepared questions. At this juncture, may I return the control of our meeting to our Toastmaster of the Day, Toastmaster Joy Villahermosa.
Thank you so much, Table Master Jack Anyete, for handling the Table Topics with equanimity. And now, may I call on our General Evaluator, Toastmaster Gina Hill, to introduce her respective evaluators, to let us know the general observations, recommendations, and their challenge to each speaker. Toastmasters Gina Hill.
Yes, Mr. Toastmaster of the Day, I will be relieving Toastmaster Gina as the general evaluator. And welcome to the third segment of our evaluation portion. Are we now ready?
Yes.
But before we continue, I just would like to clarify that if you know that you are the icebreaker and you have read your evaluation and then you are aware that you are the prepared speaker, icebreaker is usually 4 to 6 minutes only. Considering that it was unfortunate that when the timer explained his role, he was not also aware that those speakers are delivering the icebreaker, then in my opinion, as the Toastmaster of the night, as the director of the whole meeting, our responsibility is to correct. If there will be anything that has transpired we outside the rules or the guidelines of any Toastmasters meeting. Anyhow, we learn by doing, and we are improving every day as we go along with our Toastmasters journey. So may I ask again our timer, what is the time used by the two speakers?
For the formal speech Toastmaster test, the time for Marlon Bautista is 7 minutes and 59.23 seconds. And for Victoria Gold is 7 minutes and 29.15 seconds.
Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Timer. Considering that both of them are over time, then we will not declare any best prepared speaker for today's meeting. Now let's proceed with the evaluation of the prepared speaker. May call upon our first evaluator for our first prepared speaker, Toastmaster Marlon Bautista. Our first evaluator, Toastmaster June Areglo Jr.
Thank you very much, distinguished Toastmaster Tess Villanueva. Fellow Toastmasters and our guests, good afternoon once again. What a speech, Toastmaster Marlon Bautista. You are a mixture of equanimity and fluidity. Your speaking ability, Toastmaster Marlon, is so fluid and it's so spontaneous. You are a good storyteller. The audience was captivated by the way you stand up in front of us, the way that you gesture, the way that you, in general, delivered your icebreaker. That was indeed an icebreaker for everybody. And now that you open up yourself to us, then that is the first step towards improving yourself on how to be more self-confident and overcoming that nervousness that you have. You are a good storyteller in the sense that you were able to tell us, you were able to tell the audience that you were able to use the root cause analysis for you to be able to analyze what exactly is the cause of your being nervous, no? And you said your further investigation, you said that it is a lack. Yes, to continue, you said that the lack of self-confidence upon your further investigation is the lack of substantial knowledge on a subject. And your concern for others, that what will they think about you? What will the your reaction, what will they say about you? So those are upon your investigation. And your remedy, you said that you have to do more homework, do more research, no? And what other will say to you is none of your business, just mind your own business. You are really good because you also have the light moments when you say that you could not even say hi to your crush, nor you could not court your wife because of nervousness. On the next session, maybe my suggestion, TM Toastmaster Marlon, is let us know how Toastmaster will be able to help you in your journey towards achieving that self-confidence, overcoming that nervousness, so that you will also inspire us. You will also motivate all of us. But in totality, you are a good speaker, Toastmaster Marlon, and we're looking forward for more speeches coming from you. Back to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Wow, our first speaker has the potential, right, to becoming one of the best speakers in the future. What then is our second evaluator has to do to say something with our second speaker? May call upon to evaluate our second speaker, Toastmaster Victoria Ginto, our second evaluator, Toastmaster Benifer Consolacion.
Thank you very much to our general evaluator, distinguished Toastmaster Maria Teresa Villanueva, to our victorious speaker, Toastmaster Victoria Ginto. Truly, I could feel the equanimity, the calmness in your speech. Toastmaster Victoria, truly, you're able to introduce yourself in your speech. This afternoon, I was able to know that you're a lady from Mindoro. Your father asked you to stop in your during your college days. You work in restaurant. You failed and passed. You feel devastated many times. And you reminded us once again that having faith and family in your life, we will never get lost. Truly, from your name, Victoria Ginto, or Victory Gold, we are from the victim to victory, from scratch or having gold. And I could feel also that you conquer the fear of public speaking, for sure, because you're an English teacher, but truly in your speech today, to us, as not your students, but you're able to show to us that anyone can conquer our public speaking. And truly you show to us your strength, the power in your speech, Toastmaster Victoria. In Toastmasters, this is a great laboratory to improve our public speaking, our journey towards becoming a great speaker. If you may allow so, to give my honest evaluation. First, I think you raised this point, is the timing. Truly, in our next speech, it's good practice that we need to read the manual, reading the objective, not only the objective, but the timing of our speech. Second, in using notes, it's good to use notes sometimes, especially in our icebreaker speech. But I'd like to share with you that in any speech, it's good to familiarize, but not to memorize, because that's your story. You know the details of the story. No need, basically, if you would allow so, not to use the notes. Third is, speak up and slow down. Use the power of pauses. I keep on telling this one. Sometimes you can feel devastated, no? That, and then you stop for a while. Think why you feel devastated. And lastly, as I keep on telling, a great speaker is a great storyteller. When we are talking in Toastmaster, as if you're talking to someone. Maintain the pacing of calmness, because when we are calm, we're able to share the best thing. Overall, truly, you are victorious, Victoria, because you were able to achieve the objectives of the Icebreaker Project. Keep it up. Continue to inspire us. Use the platform of Toastmaster to be able to improve yourself, to become a better speaking. Looking forward for your next speeches. Back to you, General Evaluator. Thank you.
Wow. Thank you, Mr. Second Evaluator. You are indeed, Madam Speaker, a great speaker because you are a great storyteller. Now to move forward, may call upon our accounter to give her report, Toastmaster Annie Rose Labrador. But before we do that, may I call upon our timer to give us the timer's report. Toastmaster Herman.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster Tess. For the speech evaluators, for Toastmaster June Areglo, he finished his evaluation at 3 minutes and 7.65 seconds. While Toastmaster Ben Consolacion, 3 minutes and 22.73 seconds. Back to you, Toastmaster Tess.
Thank you, Mr. Timer. Both of them are qualified to be voted. You may now cast your vote as soon as you see the poll on your screen. And then to proceed further, may call again our accounter, Toastmaster Annie Labrador, to give us her report.
Thank you, distinguished Toastmaster from Tess Villanueva. For a count report, first, Amar got 4 A. Toastmaster Herman got 1 A. Our President Chat got 2 A, 1 and 1 BAT. Toastmaster June Areglo got 1 BAT and 2 Toastmaster Lilibet got 3 A. Toastmaster Rodolfo Rindal got 3 A and 1 Toastmaster Marlon got 3 and 2 BAT. Toastmaster Vicky got 3 BAT. Mine, I got 1 A and 1 Our tossan of this afternoon is Toastmaster Cara Buenavista. Back to you, distinguished Toastmaster, Ma'am Tess Villanueva.
Yes, we always have tarzan of the day, but it does not mean that we could not be one in the near future. Or probably in the near future, we will no longer be called the Tarzan of the day. And to move forward, to explain the result of her role as the grammarian, may I call upon Toastmaster Ray Kinivista.
Thank you, distinguished Toastmaster, Ma'am Tess. And for my report, for the Toastmaster who used or mentioned the word of the day, which is equanimity. Toastmaster Joy said it 6 times, and Toastmaster Herman said it once. Toastmaster June said it twice. Toastmaster Amor said it 3 times. Toastmaster Victoria said it 3 times. Toastmaster Rodolfo said it twice, and Toastmaster Ben said it once. And I also noted here some interesting words or phrases. And first is troubleshoot, lack of substantial knowledge, and adequate, believe, and never lost hope, faith, victorious, there's no stopping me, unstoppable, dream is not only a part of us sleeping, ladder to our success. And that's all for my report. Back to you, distinguished Toastmaster Mamdes.
Wow, did we mention Toastmaster Ray who used the word for the day?
Yes, Mamdes.
Yes, thank you very much. If we miss anybody who used the word for the day, just let us know. Congratulations, Toastmaster Ray. Yeah. Considering that I am also doing the general evaluation at the moment and my poll is inactivated, may I request you to please forward in private message your vote for our evaluator, the best evaluator for the day, to Ma'am Cara, to Toastmaster Cara Kinivista. Can you please cast your vote and send it privately to Toastmaster Cara Kinivista for your best evaluator? So while you are casting your vote, and we still have only 4 minutes to go before the 2 o'clock session ends, let me do my general evaluation report. Correct me if I'm wrong, I did not hear that our president told us that I call this meeting to order. So generally that is for us in the business meeting, it is mandatory, but of course sometimes we are overwhelmed So that is actually acceptable at the moment and considering that we are still a new club. And I also would like to recommend that when we start, may I request our sergeant at arms, not to mention that this is your sergeant at arms. It is already noted that the person who's going to start the meeting is the sergeant at arms. May also recommend that we no longer introduce the president when we are trying, when we call him to conduct the business meeting, because since this is a business meeting, you just have to say the statement, I now call the president, the chairman of this club, to preside over the meeting. So those are the statements that we have to tell, and no need to introduce who is the president or who is the chairman of the meeting. Now, as to the general evaluator, the table topics master, and the toastmaster of the day, we usually do not comment on the speaker's statement, because in a way, it might be interpreted that you are trying to influence in choosing the best prepared speaker, the best table topic speaker, and the best evaluator. So you might just reiterate a statement from the speech of the speaker, but we never comment or we never give interpretation on how he or she answered a specific question or how or she delivered a specific speech. Now, considering that changes in the agenda could not be avoided, I suggest that before the president or the chairman call the toastmaster of the night, I guess that you have to ask first the body if the agenda is updated at the moment, or is there any correction in the agenda. In that way, the toastmaster of the day will have the initial information, rather than at the meeting, at the middle of the meeting, the toastmaster of the day is calling the role players and the role players are not there, or the role players are not available. So I suggest that before we call the toastmaster of the day, Mr. President, if you can ask the body, is there any changes in the agenda? So that immediately the Vice President Education will say, Mr. President, Toastmaster Gina has an emergency, so we have to replace it. Toastmaster Perlita cannot be the evaluator, so we have to replace it. So in that way, the Toastmaster of the evening of the day can immediately change the role players. Now, what else? Now, in the introducing of the speakers the day, we are always recommending that we only have to use maximum two liners. And that two liners statement in introducing the speaker has to be short statement only. A one liner will do. We don't need the bio data or the summary of the bio data of the speaker, because remember, especially when you are introducing an icebreaker, you know that an icebreaker, she will introduce herself. So if you're going already to introduce her in a very long introduction, then we already defeat the purpose of the objectives of the speaker. So I suggest that in our the Toastmaster of the day should always bear in mind that in introducing the speaker, it must always be a 1 to 2 liners only. I would like to commend our grammarian, the accounter, the table topics speaker, the table topics master, the vote counter. You know, I admired all of these young Toastmasters. They really message you before they do their role on how they are going to attack their roles, on how they are going to do their roles. So I also suggest that especially the very critical part in any Toastmasters meeting is the Toastmaster of the night, the general evaluator, and the table topics master. I suggest with our BP Education and the mentors, Toastmaster Johanna and Toastmaster Perlita, that you have a meeting or a rehearsal or a practice a day before the meeting so that we can be able to guide properly the Toastmaster of the day, the general evaluator, and the table topics master. Because their performance in every regular meeting depends upon on how we are going to mentor them. So mentoring means we do it before the meeting, not on the day of the meeting. Because see, it is not good that during the meeting, someone will butt in this timer's introduction is wrong. Sorry, Mr. Table Topics Master, he's not around. Sorry, Mr. Toastmaster of the night, he is no longer or she is no longer available. So I suggest that considering that this is the three major roles in any Toastmasters meeting, then let's do a practice. Let's do the preparation a day before the meeting. Other than that, we are doing great. And I am always confident that this Toastmasters Club is the platform for us to become a better communicator, a better leader, and will always open for suggestion. Because it is only when we are open for suggestion that we could be a better communicator and a better leader. With that, let us move forward with our announcement of winners. And together, may call upon, please open your camera, our Toastmaster of the day, our President Toastmaster Jack, and our Vice President Toastmaster Cheryl, and of course the vote counter Toastmaster Cara Kinivista to announce today's best of the best.
Okay, thank you so much, General Evaluator, and to our evaluators for your constructive remarks. And truly, you are capacity. For sure, this is a lesson learned and the avenue for improvement to everyone. Now, can we call on our awards master to please announce the winners for this evening's or this afternoon's speeches. Toastmasters Cara Kinivista.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the Day, Doc Joy. So let me share with you first my screen. Okay, so again, good afternoon or good day to everyone. And congratulations to our best of the best, to our speakers who shows equanimity in their speeches. So to award first, our best table topic speaker, the best table topic speaker, none other than Toastmaster Rolando Aregla Jr., can you please open your camera for the photo purposes?
Thank you very much.
Okay. Congratulations, Toastmaster Jun Aregla. So next, for our Best Evaluator Award, for the Best Evaluator speaker goes to none other than Toastmaster Benifer Consolacion. Congratulations.
Thank you. This award also given to share with Sir Kuya Jun as my co-evaluator. Thank you.
I think that's our award for today. Back to you, Toastmaster of the Day, Doc Joy.
Okay, thank you so much, Toastmaster Scara. Now, to give us more information about the Toastmasters, do we still have time to introduce our District Toastmasters, Distinguished Toastmasters, Joey Villanueva, for an educational session?
Thank you very much, Mr. Toastmasters, and all our Toastmasters. Since we don't have any more time, we're going to do some other exploration of our portal in our next meeting. But for the meantime, since you have already received your individual letter from Toastmasters International, I think that's the email, then please click that link so that the portal will be open to you. Then, of course, I think you don't have the password. So click the forget password so that the password will be, the username and password will be forwarded to your email address. And immediately go to your portal now so that you're going to see it. I also wanted you to come and register yourself to attend the first ever virtual Toastmasters International Convention. So it will be, it's like the convention that we have for Toastmasters, for IMG, but this one will be different because it will be all over the world with all the presentation of the speakers that we have. These are all renowned speakers in the world of public speaking. And of course, we're going to see the highlight of the convention. This is the world champion of public speaking. So this is the first time that it's open, it is free, and you're going to experience for the first time how Toastmasters International is going to do the convention. As soon as you become a member, then you will see in your portal the announcement for the convention. Click it and join. And we will see you there. And congratulations again. I'm so happy and proud of who we are in IMG B1. You know, if we will have a speech contest this time, I am very sure that most of our members is going to be a runaway winners. You are very, very good. Thank you very much and congratulations.
Okay, to officially conclude this meeting, so may I call on our president, Toastmasters Jack Cañete.
Thank you very much, Doc Joy, and congratulations. Congratulations, everyone, all the speakers, all the role players for making this meeting successful. To all the officers who contributed for the success of the meeting, thank you very much. Thank you very much as well to all volunteers who help and who volunteers themselves to become speakers. We need more volunteers for our next meeting to introduce themselves. I mean, to start speakers, your first speech, you know, your speech number one. May I encourage everyone to volunteer. And our next meeting will be on September 4th. As we agreed last time that we will have first and third Friday as our official meeting. So our next meeting will be in September 4th. Thus we have more time to prepare for our speech and to meet further on how to improve our meeting as well. With that, thank you very much for your participation. At this juncture, do we have any business meeting that we need to tackle as of this moment? I believe none. But as mentioned by our district director, may I request everyone to please visit your page and do the further research or further familiarization of our web page. So we have various web pages nowadays. We have IMG and we have Toastmasters plus other organizations that we are affiliated with. But before we'll end our meeting, may I request everyone to please turn on your camera as we have our group picture first before we will end our meeting. Here we have also with us a group of participants, I believe. And if they can join us in next Toastmasters meeting, it would be fantastic. All right, so who can take a picture? Please turn on your camera, please, to have our picture. Yeah, I got it. I think we have 2 p.m. session for IMG. Right, Tita Tess? 2 p.m., right? Yeah, so, okay, we'll make it quick. So, all right, I am on page 1. Let me go to page 2. All right, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for participating our meeting. I hope that you've learned a lot for today. And keep on coming. The new participants who are here, may I request to join us next September 4 session. Hearing no further business meeting, I now adjourn this meeting. Thank you very much and God bless us all.
Very much. God bless us all.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. See you in our next meeting.
Pwede na magtagalog.
Thank you so much. Pwede na magtagalog, Tito.
Pwede na.
Tito Jack, pa-schedule na lang ng ExCom meeting immediately. And then okay. After ng ExCom meeting, i-request natin lahat ng members na mag-attend para sabay-sabay nating i-open yung ating IMG portal. Kasi each one of us has to take the assessment
Toastmasters portal.
Yes po. Para kasi makapag-assessment test na, malaman kung ano yung recommended ni Toastmaster na kung anong klaseng pathways ang ating pupuntahan, curriculum, kung gusto mo bang mastering presentation, kung gusto mo bang leadership. So, depende dun sa iyong assessment, dun sa iyong sariling IMG portal, dun mo malalaman kung anong curriculum yung tatahakin mo. So, let us all do it together para lahat tayo familiar kung paano yung ating ang ating educational road to success.
Mag-post lang tayo ng special session for intended sa Toastmaster familiarization support.
Yes po, Mr. President. Thank you very much.
We'll do it within this week, most likely.
Yes, please po. Para yung mga susunod na speaker, na-open na nila yung kanilang portal kapag ka-prepare ng speaker po nila.
Thank you.